can sense and I have felt the connections already. You're the first that I have met this young guy. Gusto po po i-welcome siya sa inyo sa hapon ito, the first night this man. At siyempre, kapasalamat tayo to the family who brought him down here with us. Amen? Welcome po natin sa hapon ito si Brother Romel. Come on, bro! Okay, ito po kayo ba? Yan! Nice job! Here is Romel de Pasis, a private nurse kung katrabaho po ngayon sa Dorchester. Yan. We had a very wonderful fellowship last time. Amen po ba? And bro, welcome again. And I hope you're gonna meet and have a fellowship and chat with the rest of the young people here. You got a lot of people who are the same age as you. Okay, si Carlo, kuya mo to, 20s or something. Tsaka si Lalia, I would like to stay for a little while. Sana makaka-fellowship mo kami. And also, we welcome din muli natin from London, traveling as far as London. Kuya Mark at saka si Joanne. Praise God, siyempre tayo for those who are traveling from Romsey, si Siapi Hilda. Ayan, ano ba natin si Lord? Sino pa? Si from Bournemouth, mga taga Bournemouth. Ayan, talagang we all support every night again. Bournemouth, Paul. Ayan. Lakasan din natin mga taga Southampton. Oh, well, I'm guys, I'm Ali Crescent. Brackenlane. Sila ka rin. Amen po ba? Yes, really, this is a wonderful thing that we always come and praise God together, even though we have a different background. You know, and welcome din natin, kasi it's my first time to see this guy being in the worship team, kasi during the first time that I introduced the worship team, I was in the Philippines. Gusto ko rin welcome din natin sa worship team si, obviously, si Jello. Welcome din natin for the new 5 members of the church who just had an encounter with God. Wow, brother, it's amazing. Welcome natin si Cyril. Come on, Cyril! Sila nga, Cyril! At saka si Kearney, si Jack, si Mika, and obviously, the last but not the least, Natalie, si Abba. So, nandiyan si Edna, si William, si Bernice, Joanna. Si Elihu, at saka si Joanna. Well, whoever these persons are, you don't know who I'm talking about, but you know what I mean. Anyway. Amen po ba? Let's all stand up and let's hear the word of God today. I'm gonna try, by the will of God, I'm gonna try to finish the word as quick as possible. Amen? In Ephesians chapter 1, verses 19 to 23, in the New Testament, ito po ang sinasabi sa Ephesians chapter 1, 19 to 23. May you have the spirit of understanding and your eyes be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope of his calling, what are the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints, and what is the exceeding greatness of his power toward us who believe, according to the working of his mighty power which he worked in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him at his right hand in the heavenly place, far above all principality and power and might and dominion, and above every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in that which is to come. And he put all things under his feet. I would like to take note of this. And he put all things under his feet and gave him to be head over all things to the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills all in all. And Father God in heaven, I lift up unto you, Father God, the message in the word that you're going to speak and minister to the heart of every single individual person in this family, O God. Amen. That may your word be spoken with clarity, with authority, and with power, and with love. We're not going to hear it only, but we're not going to change it. It will change and definitely change our lives and our worship and our love for you. And all these things we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Okay, the one we have for this afternoon is all about the privilege and power of dominion. Sabi natin, the privilege and power of dominion. Don't you know that the very first creation of God in the time of in the Garden of Eden, God has given Adam and Eve the dominion and the governance to rule over everything. Sabi natin, dominion and governance.
Dominion and governance.
To rule over everything. Now, the privilege that God has given us, the privilege and the dominion and the power of dominion, it came down from our forefathers up to our current age. Even in our generation right now, you have the power of dominion. Sabi mo, you have the power of dominion. You have the power to rule. And authority over everything. But sad to say, most of the time, it doesn't normally happen that way. Sa halip na tayo ang nag-rule over at nag-govern, tayo ang ginugovern. Are you with me? Are you with me? Sa halip, ang disenyo pala sa inyo, Lord, the design of God in your life is to govern. At saka magkaroon ka ng dominion. Pero it doesn't normally happen. So we try to unpack the reasons behind that is through the message that God is going to give us this afternoon. Sabi ko rito, dominion is a topic that most of us talk about, but few of us really possess. Okay? Not all people possess the virtue and the power and the privilege of dominion. Ano na bang areas of your life that you have a dominion? Ano bang mga parte ng buhay mo ang meron kang kapangyarihan na ikaw ang siyang, ano ba yung Tagalog ng dominion? Mag-rule over. Sabi mo, rule over. And most of the time, you are being ruled over with. Ikaw yung nirule over, ginugovern. Okay? Dominion in simplest form is power. Sabi mo na power. Authority. Control. It's a control over something or someone. Amen po ba? Alam mo, maraming tao, maging sa church, you are being controlled by something or someone. I'm gonna give you an example. And I think in the past, I have also mentioned this thing. You are being controlled by fruits. Amen ba? You are being controlled by food. Amen ba? Nawawala ka sa sarili, you're getting out of your mind every time you're hungry. Ibig sabihin, you are being governed by food. You are being governed by your tummy. Sometimes you are being governed by your pocket. Amen ba? Pag wala kang pera, your attitude is getting so temperamental. Ang kailangan mo, therapy. Do you know that? There's a lot of people, you need therapy. Pag wala kang pera, nasisira ang pagkakrusyado mo. Amen ba? Amen ba? Pag isang taka lang ng kanin ng binigay sa Diyos, yun na ang pagkakrusyado. Ano ba doon? Ano ba? You are being governed with something. Mga kapatid, you are called to govern the things, someone, or even to govern the circumstances. Amen po ba? Sometimes if things doesn't happen your way, you are being governed by the circumstances. Amen po ba? You know, last week, or last Friday, I would like to be honest with Brother Manny. No, nandito po kami, we're just about to start the encounter. Then we're expecting 10 people. And then a week before, isang pastor, we cannot make it. And then some other people said, oh, Brother Manny, we cannot make it. And to make the short story long, from 10, nung Friday na, pastor, nasabi ko ba sa'yo? Hindi ba si Brother Manny? Pastor, nasabi ko ba sa'yo? Hindi makakatay siya, nasabi ko, okay. So, ilan lang tayo today? Lima. Sabi ko, with all the kuyat and with all the midnight travel to Dorchester, lima ang aming encounter. But you know what? I never, by the grace of God, the situation didn't control me. Didn't burn me. Sabi ko, okay. Sabi, may klaro si Lord kung anong gagawin niya sa encounter. And we have seen the great things that God has planned for all of us. And sometimes we think that God can only minister to the delegates. But this time, I'm telling you, this is not only for the delegates. Tama ba ako? You've been there, right? Please say yes, please. But it's also for the people in the church. Di ba yan? Hallelujah, shout out. Hagul ko nito kanina. Anak, tahan ka na. You know the reason why? Because we are not governed. And sometimes, we cannot only see things happen the way God would like it to happen. And that's what frustrates us for most of the time. But if you know that you have been called by God to govern over circumstances, there's no way na magpa-flutter ka at saka mag-flare up ka. Bakit? You're called to govern. Ano nga sabi naman, you're called to govern. Ikaw ang mag-rule over, hindi ikaw ang mag-rule over ng sitwasyon. Amen po ba? Ayan. Another thing, sabi dun sa Genesis chapter 1, verse 16 to 18, in simplest form, it is power. Sabi ito, God made two great lights, the greater light to govern the day and the lesser light to govern the night. He also made the stars. God set them in the bottom of the sky to give light on the earth, to govern the day and the night, and to separate light from darkness. And God saw that it was good. Kahit po yung sun, the sun has been created by God to govern sa ano? The day. Yung moon to govern the night. Even God's creation and even God's miraculous creation has made with a purpose to govern. May purpose na to govern. Amen po ba? Christ has all the power. Yung next slide, sabi ko, Christ has all the power in heaven and on earth, and portions of His power has been given to everyone that believed in His name, that is living a new life by the works of His redemption. Christ has all the power on earth. Mga kapatid, and the Father that you are serving has the power, everything that we need in the earth. What else can bother you? Can I ask you this thing? Amen ba? Health? Never mind that. That's important. But you should not be so occupied with your health. Bakit? Because God, you know that God is in control of your health. Possession, God is in control of that. Your profession, your job, God is in control. You know, my father owns the NHS. The whole NHS. Amen? May stop all the time dyan. Alam mo yan? Pero ang isang ay, ang sinasabi nito, Christ has all the power in heaven and possessions in everything. Huwag ka matakot, kumawa naman ang trabaho. God's gonna assign you to reassign you. God will not let you to resign. He will just reassign you. Because God possesses everything. Amen po ba? Ano pa? The light is to govern and have dominion over darkness. Maybe some people here, you're having this kind of difficulty. If you're the only Christian in your workplace, what's normally your attitude? Ang hirap. Tama ba? Sa bus company namin, maaari siya sabi ni Kuya Mark, I'm the only Christian. Sa ward namin, I'm the only Christian. Sa hospital namin, I'm the only Christian. Sa family namin, I'm the only Christian. But who knows? But God is with you. Amen po ba? There's a lot of people here, the family, you started to have a priestly family, and it is the child, it is the daughter, it is the son who first came to know Christ. Amen po ba? Di ba, Marcy? Dati siya lang ang Kristiyano. Ngayon, the whole family started living and praising God. Mga kapatid, don't think this way, that because you are the only light in the room, the room will not be enlightened. And sometimes you just don't know, you just debate yourself, the brink's gonna come into your household, into your workplace because of you. Yung darkness, hindi niya pwedeng itaboy yung light. But the light can make taboy-taboy. The darkness. Wala na rin taboy. Taboy, alam niyo naman yun, di ba? Push them away. Hallelujah. Salamat na asawa ko. The believers have dominion over the world and even in the things in the world. Meron kayong governance privilege over the things in the world and even for the unbelievers. The unbelievers, mga kapatid, your role to the unbelievers, you have to love them, not to push them away. That's an exemption. Amen ba? Don't ever estimate the power that God has given you to share the word of God to those who are around you. But pastor, I'm the only Christian. It doesn't matter. Because on the first place, it is not you who will speak to these people, but it is the Spirit of God that will minister to them. Amen? Huwag mo sanohin. Hindi mo ito solo fight. Hindi mo solo fight ito. It is a battle that you have to encounter. You have to face with God and with the Spirit of God. We are not called to be ruled over. We are not called to be ruled over by the things of this world. Sabi pa po rito, eto maganda. Ito ang maraming bagay na hindi alam ng maraming Kristiyano. God has imparted us the dominion to rule over things and spiritual and the spiritual enemies. Amen? I would like to make it clear. The dominion and the authority belongs only to God, belongs only from God. Amen? But the privilege that God has given us, He imparted this thing to you. Kung hindi mo alam yan, you are deceived. If you know your power before God, if you know your privilege before God, that you can also govern like the way God governed other people and other situations and other things in this world, you are deceived. Kaya madalas, ang spirit of a people who is ignorant about the word of God, the privilege of God, sa word niya, kadalasan, he's got the spirit of defeat. Hindi natin kaya yan, mahirap yan, malaki yan. Are you with me? Alam mo bakit? Kasi you are not being cultured, you are not being taught that you have the privilege to govern. Amen ko ba? Pastor, mahirap yan, malaki yan, mahal yan. So what? My father owns them. My father has authority and dominion over them. And I am being imparted with that kind of dominion. Dominion not to dominate in a negative way. Dominion in such a way to influence them so that we can bring them to Christ. And they can feel the blessing and experience the blessing of God. Hindi para dominion para mo kontrolin. No, it's not to control things. It's not to dominate things. It is to use the power in us so we can glorify God. Amen po ba? Palapakan nyo nga si Lord. God has imparted us the dominion to rule over things and our spiritual enemies. Amen po ba? Pag may kaaway kayo mga kapatid, if you have enemies, especially in the human enemies, in the human form, you know what? Don't get mad at people. Because those people are not your actual enemies, but it is the spirit in the people that is your actual enemies. Always remember this. Every time you are having an encounter or difficulty dealing people, especially in the workplace, they are not your enemies. Sabi ng Panginoon sa kanyang salita, because we are not battling against human. We are not battling against man, but we are battling against principalities of this world. Amen po ba? Alam mo yung manager mo, kaaway mo? Every time na nakikita ka, lahat na lang ang gagawin mo, mali. Amen ba? Pwede magbe-break mo, magbe-break ka na, katatapos ka, papasok ka pa lang ha. Para wala ka ng ginawang mali, para bang ikaw na ang pinaka-kontrabida sa tanang buhay niya. The truth of the matter is maybe because there's a spirit in them that trying to kiss you. So rebuke the spirit. Amen po ba? Amen po ba? Colossians chapter 1 verse 11 and 13, being strengthened with all the power according to his glorious might, so that you may have great endurance and patience, and giving joyful thanks to the Father. And listen to the next verse. Who has qualified you to share in the inheritance of his holy people in the kingdom of light? You have the inheritance to govern. Amen po ba? Use your power to govern. Use your power to rule over yung mga dati nating mga bagay that can easily flare you up. Alam mo, they are governing you. Amen ba? Do you know what I'm talking about? Yung mga dati nating madaling makapagpagalit sa'yo, nag-govern siya sa'yo. Amen? Yung pang-asar, di ba? Sinabi ka lang, mga born again, mga burn again naman kayo dyan eh. Kaya mga born again, ano kasi I've heard a lot of them. Talaga ba, nakabastos eh, pero parang siya, ah okay, ganun talaga. Amen ba? Sometimes, you know, you are not governing them, they are governing you. Pero now, pasabihin mo, ah okay, ganun ba? Pwede ka. Amen? Pasabihin mo siya, you don't deserve to be a pastor. You know, narinig ko yan, you don't deserve to be a pastor, you are like this, blah, blah, blah. At one point, sabi ko, actually, I'm just wondering nga kay Lord. Sabi ko, there's a lot of better people than me. I'm just wondering, wala ko ang tinawag eh. Sabi ko, because among the people in the pastor church, I'm the least. I'm the most sinner. I'm the most sinful. I'm just wondering. Kaya sabi ko kay Lord, kung pwede, palitan ako eh. Alam mo, tumigil ng tao. Ano pa? Ano pa sabihin?
Ayun lang.
Amen ba? Because I live by grace. I don't live by merit. I live by grace. I live by the governance. I live by my inheritance from God. Everything we have, everything you can do, everything who you are, it's because of God's grace.
Amen?
Amen? Kaya yung mga taong mga maninira sa inyo at pagkano, sabi mo, ako pa rin nga ka mo, I don't deserve this one. Kaya lang, God has blessed me. Kaya lang, masabi. Kapag ginano, lalo magagalit siya. Iisip ka naman ang paraan niya. Okay lang yan, hindi ka nila gober. Amen ba? Kaya ito sabi niyo, yung susutis lang, whatever you can control, self-control and dominate you. Yung mga bagay na hindi ka nakokontrol, siya ang magkokontrol sa inyo. Dalawang bagay lang yan. It's either you control things or the things control you. Sabi mo kasama mo, if you cannot control things, come on, sabi mo sa katabi mo, if you cannot control things, the things can control you. Walang medya-medya dyan, there's no in-between. O, kumisang kinokontrol siya, kumisang ako kinokontrol na. Hindi! And most of the time, ikaw ang kinokontrol. You're not just aware. Sometimes you are being controlled by your fear. Eme ba? Hindi mo na ako atin ng midweek, umaambon. Ano ka asin? Wala ba sa nalulusaw? Eh, hindi ka mamamatay sa ambon. Eme po ba? Eme ba? May sipon ako. Diba? Wala yung sabito ba yan? You are being controlled by your fear. Amen po ba? Sometimes you are being controlled. Sorry about this. You are being controlled by mommy. Di ba? Nakatingin ka sa pastor, pero ang tingin mo sa pastor, pound siya. Ay, ganun pala. Amen ba? Mga kapatid, anything that controls your mind, you have to get them away. You have to put them away. You have to get rid of them. Amen po ba? Sabi dito, Luke 10:19, I have given you authority to trample on snakes and scorpions to overcome all the power of the enemy and nothing will harm you. Binigyan ka ng kapangyarihan ng Panginoon na mag-trample sa snakes at saka scorpions. Bakit may snakes and scorpions? Kaya lang sa Amerika, abuwat sa YouTube. Mayroon isang pastor, hindi siguro nag-aaral ng hermeneutics. They made the Bible itself sa kanyang preaching. Kumuha ng snake talaga. Oh, this is snake, invite me, but cannot kill me. Panoorin niyo po yun. Pero huwag na, baka sumali sa inispirito ng maling hermeneutics. Nagpakagat siya, pamaya, okay naman, ipipilis pa rin siya, pamaya, nalabutas ang kanya, dinala sa hospital, patay. Masabi po rito, you have given the power to trample on snakes and scorpions, ibig sabihin, from any bait of Satan. The snakes represent Satan. The snake represent temptation. Mga kapatid, you have the power over temptation. Amen ba? Hindi, pastor, hindi ko nakayanan eh. Paano ba naman yun? Eh, gumano na. Amen? Tumalikod ako, pastor. Tumakbo ako. Bumweno. Pabalik. Amen ba? The miracle is, God has given you the authority to trample on the snakes and scorpions. Meaning to say, from any form of temptation, from any form of possible sins in the future. Dominion is the ability to request or command and expect a fulfillment of that appeal. To have dominion is to be in charge. Sabi natin, in charge.
In charge.
So mga katrabaho sa hospital, you know what I mean when I say it's being in charge. You are in control. Sabi mo nga, hindi, it's not gonna happen. Okay? It will give me danger. It's not gonna happen. Stop it. You are in charge. Kung ikaw ang father ng family, sabi mo, no. I pray to the Lord, this is not the perfect will of God. We have to stop this one. Dapat ikaw ang in charge. Hindi ikaw ang pinapasunod ng sitwasyon. Hindi ikaw ang pinapasunod ng espiritu. Amen ba? Where is Pauline? Diba sa Great Revelation, sabi na, sabi natin, pastor, takot ako sa dilim. Every time I'm trying to get out of my house and get into the car, dahil merong dark alley, doon sa ina, di ba? Sasabihin doon ni Pauline, pag nasa pinto na siya, bubukas na lang niya yung ano, bubukas na lang yung car, para may ilaw. Sabi na, 1, 2, 3, tatakbo siyang dalawa. Bakit? Because the darkness could burn her. Not anymore, sabi na kanina. Not ako lumabas po. Pag ako lumabas, hindi na ako matatakot sa mga lumang mga spirit na sabi niya, here's the princess of God, please, kumapit na binga kayo dyan. Palapakan mo nga si Lord. Kaya lang hindi mo alam, you just don't realize the governing privilege of God given you.
Amen.
And the power that God has given you. Pero yung darkness, tinakot si Pauline, ano? Pero ngayon, I'm so glad and I'm so blessed. Sabi niya, lalaki ako, Pastor. Hoy! Mga demonize kayo, lalaki namin ito. Lumayan siya kayo lang. Kung araw tayo magkasama, kaya nagkala mo na. Amen po ba? For sake of God understanding, dominion is crucial in this area. A lack of understanding, ako eh. For sake of God understanding, dominion is crucial to his walk with God. A lack of understanding in this area could cause you spiritually and then naturally. Pag hindi mo alam, I'm telling you this, hindi ka lamang magsasuffer spiritually. Even in a natural way, magsasuffer ka. Sabi sa ni Lord, grab it, this is for you. At sabi mo, Lord, do I have the right to govern? Amen? Sabi ni Lord, grab the promotion. I'm not after promotion, by the way. Just for example, sabi nyo, hindi, ayoko ng promotion, tatakot ako. No, grab it! Because maybe God is giving you the privilege to govern even in your workplace.
Amen.
Mga kapatid, God has called you to be the head, not the tail.
Amen.
Sabi mo sa katabi mo, hindi ka tail.
Hindi ka tail.
Ulo ka! Amen po ba?
Amen.
Sister Agnes, lagi natin pray that the whole nursing home will come to know Christ in the name of God, will be glorified in your own workplace. You are called also to govern.
Amen.
So, imagine, I supervisor na ba doon? Because you are called to govern. Amen po ba? Maybe it's not yet time, but in the destiny that God has given you, you are called to govern. Amen? Spiritual dominion is not arbitrary rulership. It's not about going around commanding and demanding at your own discretion, but at the leading and the instructions of God. Hindi naman because meron kang govern, meron kang privilege of govern, ay ganyan ka na. Do this, do that. Okay? As you do that, stand here and sit. No. It's depending on the rulership of God. Amen ba? Yung sa kami ni Pastor ako minsan nag-uwasap ko ganito eh. Sabi ko, Mami, hindi mo naman kinakalangan mag-uwas ang plato every day doon sa, I mean, every Sunday. Sabi niya, hindi, because this is my passion. Sabi ko, okay, yun yung passion ko. Amen mo ba? Because we have the privilege to govern. Lastly, spiritual dominion begins in you. You will never be able to exercise power or authority over anything until you first conquered yourself. Yan ang sekreto. Hindi ka po pwede mag-govern sa iba kung ikaw mismo hindi mo nag-govern yung sarili mo. Are you with me? Kung sa internet lang, hindi mo mag-govern yung sarili mo, I'm telling you this, hindi ka bibigyan ni Lord ang privilege to govern others. Internet lang, 4 oras. Facebook, 3 oras. Devotion. But it's still hope. It should begin. Start governing yourself. Try to discipline yourself. Amen? Ang sabi ni Lord, to whom much is given, much is required. Kung ikaw napagkanda, wala ka ni Lord. If God has entrusted you in small things, God will also entrust you in bigger things. What is the small things? The small things start with you. Do you know that the greatest enemy yung susunod sa dyan? Brother, pardon? Yung susunod dyan? Bago ka tutulong? Our self-defense is our greatest enemy. Hindi yung pastor ang kaaway mo, hindi yung manager mo ang kaaway mo, hindi yung asawa mo ang kaaway mo. Hindi yung spirit of the world ang kaaway mo. The greatest enemy, the first and number one enemy you have is yourself. How you control yourself. How you discipline yourself. Ang sabi ni Pablo, because I subject myself into submission. Amen? I discipline myself. So that for those who don't know Christ yet, that they may come to the full knowledge of Christ. Sinasabi niyang, pinipigil ko yung sarili ko. Amen? Pinipigil ko yung sarili ko so that the people may come to the knowledge of the grace of God. Ang sabi ni Pablo, I have the right to do all things, but I would rather subject myself into submission so that the grace of God will be known to others. Kung ibang tao will be stumbled because of the things you are doing, I would rather not to do them, sabi ni Pablo. Kung sila ay matitisot sa akin, sabi niya, hindi ko ikamamatay na hindi ko gawin yon just for the sake of the gospel, because he's trying to subject himself. I would like to ask you this thing. Are you willing to subject yourself to submission so that you would win Christ, so you would win souls for Christ? Handa ka ba i-subject mo yung sarili mo sa karapatan mo? Are you willing to submit your right? I'm going to tell you this. Handa ka ba? Handa ka bang magbigay ng pera? Handa ka bang mag-subject ng iyong pride? Handa ka bang i-submit mo yung pride mo, yung right mo for the sake of those who don't and for those who can? Amen ba? Tell me this. The scope of your governance and the scope of your dominion. Okay? Brian? I can minister now. I'm gonna say it again. The scope of your dominion and the scope of your governance depending on how you subject yourself to submission. Pag hindi mo kaya disiplinahin yung sarili mo, kung hindi natin kaya disiplinahin at makapag-govern tayo sa sarili natin, there's no way that God will promote us in governing other circumstances, in governing other people, in governing other things in our lives. Kaya sabi ng Lord, bago ka, you can govern other people. Before you can govern the circumstances, you have to govern and know how to govern yourself. Alam mo ba? You have to govern yourself first. Discipline. So sabi mo, Lord, this is my right. But if I'm going to practice my right, I cannot win my friend for Christ. If I'm going to follow my dreams, your kingdom will not go further. Lord, if I'm going to be focused on my dreams and my ambition, I would like to earn money, but if I'm going to do this thing, I cannot win Dorchester, I cannot win Bournemouth, I cannot win Poole, I cannot win London. But Lord, I subject my dream to your dreams. I subject my dominion over the things that you will lack when you do. Ano ka kapatid? It's not too late. Amen? Hindi pa too late ang lahat. God is drawing you another chance, but at this point in time, God will tell you, I'm giving you authority to trample on snakes and scorpions. I'm going to give you a privilege to govern other people, but before you can govern other people, you must have to learn how to govern yourself. How about your Sunday? Can you govern yourself that you have to be in the house of God every Sunday? I'm not trying to make you feel bad. I'm trying to change the culture we have. Amen po, eh? Be in the cell group, be in a Sunday, having time with your family. Amen? It's not all about money. It's all about the things that we have to govern. But first, we have to govern sa ating mga sarili. Amen po ba? Tayo po lahat ito ngayon. I'm glad to pray for you right now. Hallelujah. I'd like to pray for you right now. As we pray for the release of the governing spirit, that the inheritance of dominion, that God has called you to have a dominion over people in a good way, dominion over things, dominion over dreams, and even dominion over circumstances of your life. Hindi ka tinawag ni Lord na maging talunan. God has not called you to be a defeated foe. God has called you to govern them, to rule over them, to have control over them. As I ask everybody, request everybody, if you could close our eyes, I'd like to pray for you right now. And if you think that you need to experience the inheritance you have from God, masasabi mo, Pastor, next time I would like to have the power of God so that I can overcome, that I can govern the situation over me. If you're that kind of person, that there's a lot of things governing you right now, but you would like to reverse the situation, you would like to be the one governing the things that enslaves you, I would like you to raise your hand as everyone's eyes are closed, and I would like to pray for you right now. Maybe you're being governed by fear. You're being governed by everything. You're being governed by your family. Natatakot ka kasi lagi kang binabawalan. You're being governed by your studies. Lagi kang takot, baka ka bumagsak. Mga kapatid, I'm telling you right now, as I pray, I'm praying that the spirit of power and courage be upon you right now. Huwag kang matatakot. If God is with you, who can be against you? If God is with you, who can be against you? The Spirit of God has not given you the spirit of fear, but God has given you the spirit of love and of courage and victory in the mighty name of Jesus. And Father God, sa oras na ito, dinadalain ko, Lord, ang mga kamay ng mga nagsipagtaas na ito, God. Dinadalain namin, Panginoon, Lord, hindi na kami magpapalupig. Hindi na kami magpapa-anger, O God, for any spirit that trying to stop me from growing. From any spirit that trying to stop me from marching forward to serve you. Right now, O God, is a new beginning in my life. I'm an overcomer. I will march forward and I will govern and rule over in everything who was once enslaves me and put me in a prison cell. Father God, I release the spirit of freedom and victory right now for every student, for every family, for husband, for wife, and even for the children and the young people right now. We thank you, O God. Thank you for the privilege of governance to govern and have dominion all over everything because of your grace, O God. We thank you, Lord, and all this thing we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Praise God. So, we have dominion over our circumstances. We have dominion over our situations. Hindi na tayo, sabi ng Pauline, wala nang rason para matakot pa tayo. So, God has given it to you. Let's use it. Kasi kahit yung kaaway ay dapat matakot sa atin. Hindi tayo ang matatakot sa kanila. It's time to give offering to give our praises to God in the form of money. Kung if you want to give, just feel free to come. The basket is here. This is our way of saying praise God for the blessings and praise God for your faithfulness. Sa mga biyaya na natanggap namin, sa mga biyaya na binigay mo sa amin, praise you and we give it back to you. Before tayo, okay, ipag-pray ko lang ito. Naghahanap ko sila ng envelopes nila. Okay, nakakagulo ko sila. Anyway, we're a bit late. It's 5:30, but please do bear with us. It's an encounter weekend, and we normally expect it like this. So it has been a fruitful and a victorious weekend. Sa mga candidates, sa mga workers. Ang daming na-reveal ng Panginoon, ang daming pinakita ng Panginoon. At hindi lang sa mga delegates, kundi pati sa mga volunteers na pumunta dito. Let us pray for this offering. Father God, Lord, we just can't imagine the length that you have to go through to pick us up, to embrace us, and to assure us that we are yours. For sabi nga ni King David, what is man that you are mindful of him? Mapanginoon, time and time again, you have shown that man is your greatest creature. It's your greatest creation, and you love man. But we don't deserve the love, but you give it anyway. Forgive us for the times that we ran away from your love. Dahil akala namin, Panginoon, na kayang-kaya namin. Akala namin na fulfilled na kami. But Lord, we just realize that apart from you, wala kami magagawa. Apart from you, Panginoon, kulang na kulang yung buhay namin. Lord, thank you that when we come close to you, you showed us your fullness. And you clothe us with your fullness. Salamat, Panginoon, for meeting every need that we have. It may be emotional, it may be physical, spiritual, and even material. Lord, every step of the way, andoon ka sa tabi namin. Thank you for your faithfulness, and thank you for your goodness. And we thank you for the blessings that we have received throughout the week, financially, Panginoon. Lord, we would like to give back what is yours. Because we want to say that we love you. We want to say, we want to honor you. And we want to give you the praise and the glory because you deserve it. Salamat sa mga buhay namin. Salamat sa mga tao na nagbigay. And Lord, yung hindi nakapagbigay, Lord, you know their hearts. And you know their situations. And salamat that you don't condemn yung mga hindi nagbigay. But rather, you would like to extend further yung pag-ibig mo para sa kanila. Thank you for the chance to give. And once again we say, this is for you, for your kingdom, and for your glory. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Praise God, that's the first part ng ating worship. Then po, you may take your seat because we would like to show you a video of the Bats 11. Okay, Comfort! Yan. And please watch this. Yan. Ito po yung matatapang na umaten na ating encounter, di ba? Yan. Parang Voltage 5 na natin, di ba? Let's Voltage! Hindi ko rin alam to eh. Nandun ba ako? Parang dumin? Sigurutin mo, okay ako dyan ah. Okay, habang naglo-load, praise God. Masa preset akong pasa-load eh. Okay na? Ayan. Alam mo na, napaka-kakaiba po itong encounter na ito. Unang una ay, this is the first encounter na we hold it for 3 days. 5 o'clock noong Friday, and then Saturday whole day, and then almost full day today. And it's really amazing kasi nakita ko namin talaga yung lahat naman pure, ano, lahat ng mga last batch, mga sumunod na yung mga sinundang batches. But what I can see in these 5 young people here, you know, they are really pure, they are so very innocent in so many ways. At nakita ko namin talaga yung desire nila, yung enthusiasm nila, they have displayed the hunger and then the thirst of them knowing God and serving God in a way. Even though they have realized that there will be only 5, but they didn't give up. Palakpang lang natin ng mga delegates. Ayan. Sa 5 delegates na ito, ay apat po sa kanila ay galing na naman ng Bournemouth. Na-outnumber na naman kami sa Southampton. Pero okay lang, we are just one body here. Whether you're coming from Southampton, Bournemouth, Poole, but the good thing is we belong to one family, and that is the family of the Lake Passion Church. Amen po ba? Amen. And gusto ko rin i-recognize, habang hinihintay natin na lumaki si Lord, gusto ko rin i-recognize yung mga cell leader nila. Yung cell leader po nila ay si Nico at saka si Cassie. Palakpakan natin si Nico at si Cassie. Okay. I think, tatlo ba doon? Tatlo doon ay galing sa cell group ni Nico at saka ni Cassie. Atilea, you must be proud of your children, you know? Palakpan niya natin siya, Pilea, siyempre. Then, Stan, if you're ready. Palakpan din natin yung, dahil Walters 5 sila, mayroon din yung Walters 5 group, kasi nagdala nila si Rika. Yan. Palakpan natin Walters 5, si Pauline, ang ating coordinator. Coordinator mo ng ating encounter si Ate Pauline. Ate Pauline, tumayo ka. Yan. Naman, napakaganda po ng leadership niya po rin talagang, Pastor, time na, talagang on time kami sa lahat. Okay? But, i-advise ko lang, may mga pagkakataon talaga, may mga move ng Holy Spirit na hindi talaga tayo mag-i-stick sa time. Kasi po kahapon natapos kami, as early as 7 o'clock, kumakain na po kami. But, kasi si Oliver ay pinagturo natin ng 8-point commitment at medyo na nagdelay ng konti but in the end it went well naman. Palakpan din natin si Oliver para sa mga sa ato. Siyempre si ang lahat ng mga nandito, ang mga kapatahan, si Darika, palakpan na niya sa sarili niya. Si May, si Lian, talaga na Friday Pastor last Friday. Gusto ko yung mention, special mention, itong kabataan ito, hindi ako magwa-wonder sa araw magpapastor ito, tandaan ito. Hindi na si Nico, akala nyo si Nico lang. Alam mo, alas 11 natapos na ng trabaho, tinatry niyang matulog, alas 2:30, gising na! Alas 2, may, di ba alas 11 na tapos? Hindi ko ako makatulog. Parang mag-e-exhaustion lang, di ba? Excited. Palapakan natin muli si Jello. Yan. Dito ko ba? Siyempre, special mention natin, ang all-around helper, ang all-around helper, driver, chopper, cameraman, si Junior! Yeah. At siyempre ang mga walang kasawa-asawang nagluluto, lahat na lang pwede luto ay luluto. Ayan, si Ate Joanne at saka si Charito. Grabe, the crew was really overflowing yesterday. Sino ko ba? Palakpakan niya natin yung ating mga bago at saka mga lumang teacher. Sa si May, siyempre si May naging teacher sa ngayon. First time naging teacher din ni Danica. Bote ka nang mag-collapse kanina, habang ito ang bote. Sabi ni Danica kanina.
Ikon na pa.
Hindi ako lumilingon, nandun ako sa grupo. Hala ka dyan, mag-collapse ka dyan. But I love Danica, no? Sino pa may mga una nagturo? Obviously, si Father Ferdy, nag-ano ba? Nagturo na si Dante, at nakalap pa. Wow! Talagang isang to, akala ko magkukulapso isang araw eh. Talagang si Brian talagang all the acknowledgement recognition. Sino pa ba?
Pao!
Si Teacher Pao, first time na rin nagturo, grabe. Sinimension ko nila si Lian at saka si ito, the wonderful couple na ito, sabi ko nga, you are sleeping giants. Okay? Pag ito, ginising ni Lord, mukhang ginising na today. Sabi ko, alam mo, you will not be surprised if one day, or one of this year, one of this month, we're gonna have a passion church Bristol. Wala pa nga namin si Lord. Sino pa ba? Isa-isa natin. Siyempre, ang walang kakupas-kupas sa mga pang-Alaska. Faithfully doing the job. Hello? Papa natin si Nino. Walang turo si Nino. First time nagturo? Sa encounter, guru na sa dati, pero it is a longer exposure niya. This time, walang pa natin si Marcy. Yan. So, siyempre, palapakan din natin yung mga sumuporta, hindi pa sila pwede magturo. With exception, siyempre, ni Brian. Narito tayo, galing ng trabaho, si Marvin. Palapakan natin si Marvin.
Yan malaking si Gia, malaking teacher, si Winnie, talagang all support sa atin. Palakpakan din natin si Paolo. Si Jen, grabe si Jen. Ang mira, Holy Spirit kanina siya una. Ayun ba? Si Matt, ha? O kami niya si Matt kasi may trabaho. At saka si Gia. Basically po, ang nangyari po nung weekend, sa hindi yung sinasadya, ano po nangyari? Naging youth encounter. Naging youth encounter siya. Kaya it's really such a wonderful thing na God has orchestrated sa atin. Pero siyempre, napapasalamatan din natin ang walang-walang sawa talaga. Si Sister Bang, where's Sister Bang? Okay, palapan na si Sister Bang, aling din sa all of the crowd. Palapan din natin yung, siyempre, yung mga nag-accommodate nga pala, nandiyo pa ba sila? Palang-palangan natin, i-recognize natin si Ate Sorel at saka si Kuya Aris. Si Kuya Sorel at saka si Ate Aris. Nabaligtas na. Okay. At saka din yung isang bahayan ni Sister Bang at saka ni Buddy Manny, nag-accommodate sila. At saka nag-accommodate din, dito hindi lang nag-accommodate, pero nadalangin din. Yan, kaya sumakachata ang ulo. Si Ate Selly, palang-palangin si Ate Selly. Saka si Brian, nag-accommodate siya ng mga workers. Palakpang ngayon natin. Si Ati Yoli, nandito na si Ati Yoli. Okay? Pero, kinapanggit ko kayo o hindi ko nabanggit, we all these things sa inyo po lahat, kila Ati Marlene, kila Sister Ellen, kila Sister Agnes, you know what? Alam ko, in one way or another, you all pray for us. Kasi hindi naman mangyayari ito kung kami-kami lang. Tayo po lahat ito. Ito ay sa joint effort ng pastor. Kaya pala kapag po natin tayo lahat. Okay? Gusto lang salamat sa accommodation. Yan. Saka salamat sa support na nandito tayo. Pero gusto ko pasalamatan the two most important persons sa lugar na ito. Ang isa sa mga bukod sa coordinator, isa yung arrange ang lahat. You know, I'm so blessed. From the bottom of my heart, I would like to thank you. Okay? Gusto ko rin pasalamatan itong kaibigan natin, itong magagawa natin, kasama sa leadership ng church. Talagang kahit pagod na pagod ito, alam ko hindi siya napapagod sila, pero walang sawa and everything. Alam ko nga sa akin, palapakan din natin si Lord sa buhay ni Brother Manny. Yeah! At siyempre pa, hindi ko makakaya rin ito kung wala yung aking asawa. Talagang one of my number one critic. I'm so thankful about. And even though sometimes we differ in so many ways, but he's so submissive. I'm really glad. And maraya pang ginagawa si Lord sa kanyang buhay. At yung pagkulos ko. Palapakan din natin si Maswala Ehi. Praise God! Yeah. Okay, from the bottom of my heart, this last encounter, bago ko ipapanood sa inyo yan, nagpapasalamat po ako. It's very special, sabi nga namin, napaka-special ito. Salamat din Kuya Mark at saka sila dahil pinahiram niyo sa amin si Marcy, na lang ko talaga. Alam kong, it must be a time of mercy with you as a family, pero pinahiram niyo sa amin. We're really all a grateful heart para sa inyo. Yan. Nagpapasalamat din po ako, this batch 11 na encounter is so different because this is a time na I can say in a way, I almost relax. I just sit back, tingnan ko lang kayo. Brother Manny is overseeing everything. And then, nandiyan naman si Ate Pauline na napaka-strict talaga sa oras and everything, napaka-perfectionist. Yung mga teacher, napakaraming revelations sa teacher. Nakita ko po yung mga kabataan ito, mga kapatid. Alam ko, patuloy po natin yung pananayangan ng kabataan. Yung buong church, pero particularly po yung kabataan. Ngayon, nakita ko the revelations, how they do the teaching. Grabe ho yung mga revelations. Yung mga napaka-sensitive na dinidiscuss, pero pag dinidiscuss, nilalagay ang light lamang. And that's a wonderful gift sa teaching. So, palapakan po natin lahat ng mga nalilahan. Salamat ako sa inyo, guys. Kasi talaga na nakapag-relax ako. I enjoy the whole encounter. 3 days, pero hindi po kami ganun masyado na pago this time. Dahil sa mga tulong na ito, okay? Panoorin natin ito, itong video na ginawa ni Brother Jimmy.
I'm not afraid.
Simulan na natin. Mag-aabutin tayo ng gabi dito. Sa mga panood.